Hi again, it's David with Ash&Ember Woodshop, and today we're going to go over how to install your OMTech laser tube. So let's go dive into it. All right, so once we're in the back of the compartment where the laser tube is going to be installed, you'll notice a couple of things. One, some labels that say bracket position. Those, I could tell you right now, the bracket position is not going to line up with the laser bracket. Those particular stickers are not going to correlate with any of the mounting brackets on your laser. So when you initially put your laser tube in, you're going to want to make sure that the front of the laser tube is not right against the bracket of mirror one. You're going to want to have at least a finger length in there so you can get something in there to clean that little transparent lens that's on your laser tube. Now once you've made sure that your laser tube is not right up against mirror one here, you're going to want to make sure that the orientation of the tube is not having these tubes rest right on the bracket or the housing of the laser tube here. You don't want this to be crimped or any type of pressure that's gonna be on the water line. So now on the back side, opposite side of the mirror one, you're going to have the housing for the opposite end, your input water line of the laser tube. You'll see on 80W and 100W that it's going to have an extension on the outside right here, and that's just because your laser tube is longer than the width of your machine. So once you have your laser in here, you'll see that it has these little yellow cushions for your laser tube. You're going to sit your tube in there. You're going to make sure that those brackets go around your tube and it is sitting in an even area all the way around. You're not having pressure on one side or another, and that your tube is relatively level with inside the bracket. Now you'll see on my laser tube that I actually have this. It's a high voltage wire connector. OMTech actually gives you this where you put your positive line, your red wire into. You would twist those in there, shove that in, and then they give you kind of a mixture that you would put in here. It would harden and you can mount that to your laser tube. I opted to not use this and go with this. It's a very simple installation. One wire comes in, it has a set screw that puts it in, another wire comes in, set screw, and then this gets twisted together. It makes it easier for disassembly, taking it apart if you need to. And for me, I just felt it was a little safer and it actually provided a better connection for my wires. And I'll have a link to that in the description. Also, when you are installing your laser tube, make sure that your water lines aren't running underneath the tube here, that they're coming along the top. Your wires are along the top. Nothing's getting jammed or pinched in between your laser tube and the housing. Now for your negative connection, a simple wire nut will work. Just tie the two black wires together. Again, making sure you're not pinching any of your water lines or any wires between the tube and the housing. Once you have your tube in place and your wires connected, then you're going to make sure that you have your water lines connected to the correct inlet and outlet. So here you'll see marked on the laser tube, it says water outlet. This will be your water outlet tube that goes into your chiller on the water outlet. And then you're going to follow this and you're going to enter your inlet on the water inlet on the opposite side of the tube. Do not get this confused. So that's it for the installation of your laser tube. I apologize for the tight quarters. My laser is in an area where it's pretty close to the wall. I hope that the information provided in that video is helpful for you. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. And if you found this useful, please like and subscribe. Thank you.